So, do you want to end this then?
I don't want to hurt you any more than I already have.
So help me, I can't stop, I can't go. Like I'm out of water, so I'm beat though. Something's breaking and I don't know what to do. But what I do know is that I need you to help me, I can't stop, I can't go. Like an out of water, so I'm beat though. Something's breaking and I don't know what to do. Am I breaking down?
Jaimie.
Julie. Wow, it's been a while. You've changed quite a bit.
You've changed your hair, I see. Your hair was long the last time I saw you.
I see that you're dressed up nicely. I wonder where you're going.
I wonder why you cut it. You've always wanted it long. You thought you could do more with long hair.
Your eyes. I mean, I remember when you were laying on my chest. And it felt like a moment ago. The first thing I noticed in that moment is your eyes.
Yes, that was the night when we were in the back of your car and we both were listening to the Beatles song yesterday.
I do remember. Yeah, the Beatles song, yesterday. You then asked me a question.
What is your first impression of me?
I answered, your eyes.
My eyes? Why is it my eyes?
Your eyes tell a lot of the beauty within you, and it's truly beautiful. You then followed me up with another question.
Well, have you ever fallen in love?
First time. This could be my first time. But first, just like everyone else in the world, we both started off as complete strangers.
We were both so awkward and quiet.
But you were so eager to get to know me.
And I even asked you about your tattoo.
You asked me my favorite foods, my drinks, my colors? Where do I want to travel? What do I do for free time?
The fact that we have so much in common is funny.
Do you know what's funnier? That night, we saw a couple disgustingly making out.
But shame on us. We became that couple a minute later. Was so magical. We stayed up all night painting the town red together. It's almost like a movie in my mind.
Then, night after night, I was always excited to come see you. I didn't care how busy I was. I wanted to see you badly.
Every night, you talk endlessly, making me see just how truly special you are.
And every night, I was happily painting the town in every color with you. We were so reckless.
Never thought that finding you in this hopeless place can bring so much magic to my crude world.
We then set our date, June 12, 2015. I set it in every calendar I own to remind me of this special day.
Hey, Julie.
Hey, Francisco. What's up?
Nothing, just trying not to fail classes, but I saw your presentation. You did really good.
Oh, thanks. You too. I like what you're doing out there.
Nah, I was horrible, but are you waiting on a ride? I could give you one if you want.
Yeah, actually I am. Oh, there he is.
Oh. Hey, Princess.
I gotta go. I'll catch you next class?
Yeah, next
okay.
class.
Okay, see ya.
Bye.
Hey, baby.
Hey.
From then on, we were so perfect. Nothing seemed to break us apart. I never felt like home to anyone else. I knew you were different from others I encountered in my life.
So much stuff happened for the past 4 months together. We finally moved into our first home.
With our dog, Gus.
We then became one. We both become part of each other's lives and routine. It's like my morning isn't complete without kissing you before I go to work.
Good morning, beautifuls.
Good morning.
How'd you sleep?
Good.
Wait, have you been looking at me this whole time?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I love you.
I love you too. I love you more than anything in this world. You're amazing and beautiful and smart and kind. And I love everything about you. You're one of the lights in my life. And I hope it's always going to be like this with us. And I promise that I'll take care of you with everything. Every single day, I'll always make you happy.
I promise to hold your back 100% too. Let's stop this whole melodrama. I'm gonna take a photo of you.
Okay.
But sometimes, getting too much comfortable can forget what we established on our own.
Oh, fuck! Hey, babe. Babe. Babe, wake up.
Hey, have you eaten?
Yeah, babe, I have. Babe, I'm so sorry. They gave me so many files at work, and time flew by. I promise I'll make it up to you.
It's fine, baby. Happy second year anniversary. Let's go to bed. You have an early meeting tomorrow.
Happy anniversary, I guess.
2 years later of being together, we both created different priorities besides our relationship.
By the 30th of November. Come on, get it done, Jaimie.
By then, I got busier and busier.
More work piles up, and less time for us. I admit, I kind of miss those times. Those times when we were still reckless and didn't care what could happen tomorrow.
But with how busy I was getting, it was really hurting our relationship. Like when you had things to do and you wanted me to be there for you. With how busy I was, I couldn't even be there for you. And even when I got home from work, you would always wait up for me and always give me the biggest hug and the biggest kiss ever. And now it's just gone.
Hey, babe.
I made you breakfast.
Babe, I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna have to grab something to go because I'm running super late and I have a meeting with a client at the office in an hour.
That's fine. I'll just make you some lunch then. Babe, Reiki is going on a double date tonight and she's inviting us to go. Do you think we can go?
In all honesty, babe, I don't think we're gonna be able to go. I have so much to do and I'm working so hard to finish all these deadlines. In fact, I gotta go right now. Bye, babe. Have fun. I'll call you later.
I guess 2 years in the relationship, we don't see eye to eye anymore.
We became colder. Busier. And argued many times.
Every single time I'm texting my friend, you always want to know everything. Come on, every single time.
You cried yourself to sleep. And I crumbled even more. It's hard to admit, but I knew in the back of my mind, I was already hurting you. But with how busy I was, just in the blink of an eye, our relationship was hurting, and there was nothing we can do about it.
Look, that's why! Look at you! Oh my god!
Julie.
No!
It's gonna be fine.
It's gonna be like me to complain.
Hey, is everything okay? Are you alright?
Yeah, it's just my boyfriend. He hasn't texted me since this morning. I'm kind of worried. It's our fourth anniversary today.
Hey, well, maybe he's gonna surprise you. Like, come on, don't overthink it. Maybe he's just busy at the moment.
Maybe you're right. I'm just overthinking it.
Yeah, come on. I do the same thing, but, you know, 80% of those thoughts are lying to you.
Thank you, Francis.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, Julie. There's a really good Korean barbecue spot down the street. Did you want to go and try it out?
Sorry, Reiki. I'll pass. Jaimie just texted me. He's taking me out. We're having sushi. It's our fourth anniversary, actually. Yeah.
Oh, congratulations. Francisco, you don't have class till later, right? Did you want to go and try it out?
Of course. Yeah.
Okay. Julie, you don't mind, right? No, you guys have fun. Okay. Okay. Bye.
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 Babe, sorry I'm running late. I just have so... Babe, what's wrong? If it's because of me, I promise you, I had a lot of files at work, and that's why I got caught up in time, and I just wasn't aware of my time. If we leave right now...
You're supposed to be here by 3:33, and now you're an hour late.
But babe, I'm telling you the truth. I got caught up with a lot of files at work, but I promise you, I'll make this up to you.
Whatever now, I'm used to it.
Wait, don't leave. Hold on. Hold on. I said, hold on. Literally, I left my fucking job for you to be acting like this? I had so much work out there, and I left it all to come hang out with you on our anniversary.
So I have to be grateful then? Well, thank you. Thank you for leaving your work a little bit early for your girlfriend on our fourth anniversary. Thank you. You're such a good boyfriend.
That's not what I meant. You knew exactly what I was trying to say. You missed my words. What? Now you're mad about the bed out of everything? I just got home from work to spend time with you. Like, what's going on with you? This is quite uncalled for. This isn't a nice way to treat your boyfriend.
What about you, huh? What do you know about treating your girlfriends right?
What are you even talking about now? Like, we're working out just fine. We were
no,
just
we're
fine.
You know damn well we're not okay. We have not been okay, Jaimie. Jaimie. How insensitive can you get?
Insensitive? Me? Out of everything I've done for you? Where did this even come from?
This is not about you being late tonight. It's the fact that our relationship is falling apart and you're choosing not to see it.
I'm sorry.
Apologizing. Again? What makes this any different from all of your previous apologies? Every time that you don't reply to my text, whenever I keep my hopes up, or whenever you couldn't make time for me, every time that I could, I keep expecting I lose connection to you. Jaimie, I'm asking for one day. Day in case you forget. I didn't love you for you to just keep apologizing for me. We both promise for each other. We're gonna be there for each other. But why do I feel like I'm fighting this all alone?
I didn't know you felt this way. I've just been going through so much and I've been so exhausted. I'm a dog shit boyfriend.
What?
I don't deserve you at all. I just don't know what I want anymore. I don't see the point in this relationship at all.
So, do you want to end this then?
I don't want to hurt you any more than I already have.
Coming. Hold on. Julie, what are you doing here? Oh. It's okay. It's okay. Come inside and we'll talk about it, okay? Julie,
I would have dropped everything to come and pick you up. And plus, you live really far. Here, be careful. It's a little hot, okay?
Thank you, Rocky, for letting me stay here.
Of course. You can stay here for as long as you need. But how are you?
I don't know, I couldn't believe he could give up so easily.
He's not different from any guys I've met. God knows I could still hold him, even if it's so hard to love him. How could he do this to me? Am I not enough?
Julie, I may not know all the answers to your questions, but sometimes the things we want the most don't happen conveniently. It's the least that comes unexpected. Just like love. And love is the most unsure thing in the world, and you'll never know how things will go. But you can't measure your worth through this relationship. But at least you have those good moments with him.
How could he promise the world and left me in the cold? It hurts a lot, Reiki.
Aren't those moments also the most beautiful things you've ever experienced? You guys met in the most unexpected way, in the most unique and special situation. I'm sure he's feeling the same way as you. Even I get jealous sometimes of you guys. Maybe that's why it hurts that much. Because you were so happy with him. But you have to let go, Julie, and carry yourself back up. But don't worry. I'll be here to help you.
You're more than just my best friend. You're like my little sister. It hurts me to see you in pain.
Julie, you haven't eaten all day. Are you okay?
I'm not hungry.
Okay, let me know if you need anything, okay?
I don't think you understand how worth it you are. And I will continuously remind you of that.
He doesn't love you anymore. He doesn't remember any of the moments that you guys shared together. It's over. You think I like seeing you do this to yourself? This isn't how you should be living.
You know why you don't understand me? Because you never felt this love before. I hope you feel this one day.
Even at times when you were in denial, it hurts me to see you in pain, but I want you to be strong. You've been through so much pain, and many people have given up on you. And that pain clouded your mind.
Out in the garden where we planted the seeds,
and made you think that you were undeserving.
By the cracks of his skin, I climb to the top.
But please, don't forget that your family and I love you so much.
When the guys came around to blow me down, held on as tightly as you have.
Thank you.
sorry for hurting you. It's okay.
I do know what real love feels like. And I love you enough that I don't want to see you hurt anymore.
Thank you.
You know I'm always going to be here for you.
Thank you for everything.
It's okay. It was ugly anyways. You deserve better.
Thank you.
This is the beginning of the end. A new chapter for you to start loving yourself. We'll be here when you think that there's no way out of this dark journey of yours and gradually bring you back the light you lost. To continuously remind you that you're worth every battle and we would never get tired of you. Until you finally see it. Until you are ready.
Are you ready?
Reiki was right. Love can be the most unsure thing in this world. You wouldn't know what the universe has in store for you.
You might wake up one day and realize you don't love the person you wake up to anymore.
Or one day you'll see yourself dancing alone on a tightrope filled out of promises, but the coolest deed a universe can do to you
is meeting someone that will touch your heart unexpectedly and then let you fall as hard as it can be.
And pluck it away in the coolest way possible. How does people cope through this heartache and love again? How big are their hearts to accept all those pains and move on? Went to those places we've been to.
To every corner where we both painted it with fondest memories.
Places where I started to realize how special you were. Came here thinking I could take in all what's left of us.
Maybe a last kiss and tell you that I love you and whispered goodbyes.
I was hoping that maybe I'd see you around the corner having the same thought as mine, but I know it's all in my head.
They said, if you can't try to avoid accidents, turn them into an adventure.
Meeting you was rather a movie played in my mind, but everything that turned sweet to sour became a memory to keep forever.
Or a lesson to learn from.
Those people who could love again after a painful breakup, are not reckless or foolish.
They're brave and courageous. They love without thinking how long it would last.
They just enjoy the present and love without being scared of what comes next. Because life isn't made to last forever. Perhaps made out of beautiful and sweet moments. I don't regret loving you at all. I will still love you even if you broke my heart. Even if it means loving you from afar, I'll still choose to forgive you.
You are the only person I've ever completely given myself to. I hope someday you'll find it in your heart to forgive what I've done.
And I hope you could forgive my shortcomings too.
And thank you for your precious time. for loving you unconditionally. But even then, and now, you'll always hold a place in my heart.
And I will still wish for your happiness, even if I'm not a part of it anymore. You are still my home when my hopes get exhausted. Our love may be a movie in my mind. Sadly, like any movie, it has to end somewhere. We may not made it, but at least we met.
Hey, Francisco. How are you?
I'm good.
It's been a year since we last talked.
It has. It's been a year. How are things with you and your boyfriend? I'm sorry. I know you kind of cared for him.
No, it's okay. It's been a year, actually.
I'm sorry.
No worries. I'm actually moving out of Reiki's place next week. And, I found a new apartment near my work.
Oh, that's amazing. How's that?
And just going with the flow. Certainly not overthinking things, because someone told me that 80% of those thoughts are lying to you.
Yeah. That person must have been really smart. But what are you about to do?
Nothing actually. I'm gonna book an Uber home.
I mean, I stay close by. I can give you a ride if you want. Like, no pressure.
Sure.
What if our stars aligned this time?
Maybe another chance to make things right?
Julie! But sometimes, those thoughts, words, and what-ifs are better left unsaid.
Somebody told me you still love me, don't know why. Nobody told me that you only need a time to that you want to come back when our love is real again. Let me be the one to break it up so you don't have to make excuses. We don't need to fight a setup where someone wins and someone loses. We just have to say
take your special memories, so in many years to come, we can have it. And this is for every time that we miss each other, and if we feel like we're giving up on each other, we'll
we'll have something to remind us of how we started.
I would never let that happen.
Let's take it.
Someone wins and someone loses.